Jonathan Villar. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1. Very mild temperatures as we begin tonight. 58 degrees here at first pitch. The 1-2. Hit softly down the line at first. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Duvall is there and he has it for the first out. So bases are empty with one gone and ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. A ball and two strikes.
Man, you don't see this in today's game that much. A guy who's willing to work east-west consistently with a great cutter two-seamer combo.
Fly ball to straightaway left. Rosario is under this one, and that's out number two. Next up from New York, Francisco Lindor. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. The set and the 1-1 pitch. And there's ball two now.
Two balls, one strike.
A three ball, one strike count to the Mets shortstop.
3-1.
Pete Alonso would be next. The 3-1 pitch. And we're just underway from Truist Park. Sliced hard on the ground, and that finds its way through for a base hit. So on a full count pitch, he's able to get on base and keep the inning going.
Batting fourth, the first baseman, Pete.
In now, Pete Alonso. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Lindor rounds the corner and is headed home. And a relay to the plate, but not in time as he's across with the run. At the plate, Michael Conforto yanked on the ground down the line. And on to first with it is Freeman, and that'll end the inning. In is Jorge Soler. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home. Line towards center field. Nimmo is right there, one down. Stepping in for the Braves, Freddie Freeman.
The first baseman.
One out, Freddie. Nobody on.
Freeman.
Two balls and a strike to Freeman. Two and two. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Bases are empty here with two away, and that'll bring up the exciting Ozzie Albies.
Albies.
The 1-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery.
No.
These are the great matchups that happen throughout the course of a game. I don't think as a pitcher you can give in right here. He's a great hitter at the plate. He knows it. You know it. Keep executing. Maybe get him to roll something over.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
Austin Lowry.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Now a check swing, but he does manage to hold up in time. Ball three.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
The next 3-2. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
The center fielder.
So here is Adam Duvall trying here to plate the tying run from second. The set and the 1-1. Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw to first is going to be in time, and the Braves rally comes up short as that's out number three. And now here is Javier Baez. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Ready with the 1-1. A ball and two strikes now. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. The 1-1.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Lifted down the line and left, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Another 2-2 offering. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now. Next for the Mets, James McCann. Two out, nobody on. Hit back up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Batting up, the pitcher, Carlos.
At the plate now, Carlos Carrasco fouled off. Here's another 1-2. Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact.
Well, he's been laboring a bit through these first two innings of work. That's 37 pitches, and ideally, he'd be closer to 27 instead.
The 2-2 one more time. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. And stepping in, Eddie Rosario. Previous battles with Carlos Carrasco. He checks in here as a 323 batter. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw to first is in time for the first out. Now into the box, Travis d'Arnaud. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a line drive. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Batting it. That's shortstop. Dansby.
Stepping in now, Dansby Swanson. One and two now as that one's fouled off. From the belt, kicks and deals. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Batting
next
ninth.
To hit will be the pitcher, Jesse Chavez.
Jesse Chavez.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this will land untouched. The 1-2. On the ground a second for Baez. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Top of the third set to get underway, and next will be the switch hitting third baseman, Jonathan Villar. The 2-1 waves and misses for strike number two. He pulls this one into right. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. So with that, the Mets have a runner aboard to get the inning underway. Now a move over to first, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. VR on at first, nobody out. Into the box, Brandon Nimmo. Right there at the belt, 1-2 now.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
Nimmo with an even count of 2-2 now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And he missed with it here, so now it's a full count, 3-2. This one's blooped out toward right center field, and that's in there, base hit. And he's safe.
Now batting, shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
Standing in now, Francisco Lindor. Popped him up. And no one will get this one.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Duvall is there. Let's see if they try it. And they decide not to push things here with one away as he'll hold on at third base.
The first base.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. An RBI double is what he was credited with his first time around. Now the 2-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Good time to try to put the ball down in the strike zone. You can either get a strikeout.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
Up next to the net, the right fielder.
So now to the plate, Michael Conforto. A leap here, but it ticks off his glove. And he'll reach first safely. And the run will score from second as now it's a 3-0 game.
Now the second baseman.
To the plate now, Javier Baez. Oh, they'll run this one in on him and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
I know he's been struggling early, but that pitch right there, well-executed changeup. If he can mix that in, maybe he hangs around for a little while longer.
The 1-2.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2. Swing and a line drive. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
Now batting, number six.
So here's Jeff McNeil, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. It looked like the fastball got away from him there.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Stepping in, Jorge Soler hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
3-1 to him now. Fouled away. The next 3-2. Swing and a liner. But this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again. 3-2. Hard hit ball to second. There's Baez. And that's out number one. So the leadoff man's gone, and that'll bring in the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. One out, nobody on.
Freeman.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Ranging back is Nimmo. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Digging in, the switch hitter, Ozzie Albies, worked a walk his first time up.
Albies.
The 1-1.
Ball. Two balls, one strike.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The next 3-2. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder, and that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
Into the box now, Austin Riley, skied into very shallow right. Conforto is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. Drew Smyly answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Stepping in once again is James McCann. Previous battles with Drew Smyly. It's been a steady 5-for-9. Two of those hits were for home runs. Ground ball left side. Reined in. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. So here now is the pitcher, Carlos Carrasco. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Duvall is there now, and he has it, two gone. So two are gone in the Mets' half of the fourth, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat. All even at 2-2, here it is. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Brandon Nimmo would be next. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. Brandon. Now a throw over. Runner back standing. VR is off of first with two away. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Digging in will be Adam Duvall. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Carrasco pauses. Here it is on a ball and two strikes.
Gotta believe that was a mislocation because it missed right down the middle. This guy's gonna have nightmares at the plate thinking about missing that one.
And another foul ball.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. So next to hit is Eddie Rosario. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. Rip down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. There's ball four. Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. Runner at first here, one man out. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Slapped hard the opposite way. In there, a base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
The batter number 7, shortstop Dansby.
At the plate, Swanson. Dansby Swanson, and it's fouled away. Swing and a liner. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out. So in now is the Atlanta pitcher, Drew Smyly. One and two now to the Braves pitcher.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. Previous battles with Drew Smyly, he's a 333 hitter. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. No one on with one down, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. And now, Michael Conforto trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. Line shot to second, but it's caught and the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Jorge Soler. The 2-2. Check swing in the dirt, but he went around. The throw down to first, one away. One out, base is empty, and that brings in Freddie Freeman.
Freddie Freeman.
The 1-1 is a fastball that misses. Good pitch there on the inside, black called the strike. Swing and a looper to left. VR backs up and takes care of it. Two away. Two gone now in the Atlanta half of the fifth. And that'll bring up Ozzie Albies. The 1-1. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Conforto has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Javier Baez. Now a swing and a deep drive to left. Gone to lead off the inning.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
Stepping in now, Jeff McNeil. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
Rosario comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Stepping in next, James McCann, 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Duvall is there, two gone. So here's the Mets pitcher, Carlos Carrasco. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far. Here's a fastball that's wrapped out to left center, and this is going to get down for a base hit.
Now batting, the third baseman, Jonathan Villar.
Standing in now, Jonathan Villar. On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
Working for the punch out and the offering. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away. And whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four according to Woody Keller. So here's Brandon Nimmo. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Ball hit out to Albies at second base. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Seth Lugo enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Now the Atlanta number four hitter, Austin Riley. Past matchups against Seth Lugo, he's 1-for-2. Now the 1-1 pitch. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
Hey, every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And gone, an absolute bomb.
Most pitchers aren't going to throw this guy much of a fastball to try to challenge him, because this guy can hit him a mile, just like he did with that swing right there. Impressive power.
In now, Adam Duvall. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch. Into right center, that's a base hit.
The left fielder, number 8, Eddie.
Into the box, Eddie Rosario. And he misses, 2-1. Duvall gets his lead at first, nobody out. Right side, but it's well foul. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Next, it'll be Travis d'Arnaud. It was a base hit last time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. To second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. In the box, Francisco Lindor. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Under this one is Soler, and he'll handle it for the first out. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
2-1.
And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on balls. The 1-1 home. Yanked hard, but foul to the right. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2. Here's Javier Baez. It was a solo shot for him in his last at-bat.
That last at-bat, that showed me something. It's not that easy to hit a changeup over 400-plus feet out of the ballpark. So this guy gets some good extension, strong wrist, and this guy's got some terrific bat speed.
You could tell by the hitter's balance after that swing that he's seeing the ball really good. His timing is right there, and I expect him to catch something clean.
And that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now. Chris Martin is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number six spot following the double switch. Jock Peterson is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. To the plate now, Jeff McNeil. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. All even now, 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And he fouls this one off. Alonso over at second. Baez on at first with two down. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Back-to-back sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all in the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one, though.
Hit hard down the line. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. Into the box now, James McCann. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
2-2 to the Mets catcher. Down the first baseline. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. A shot down the first baseline. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. McNeil ignores his coach. He's chugging for home. Tag is there, and he's out trying to score from first as the second run. Heath Hembree will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jose Peraza will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. Fly ball out toward left center field. Nimmo in pursuit. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Here's Jock Peterson now. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. The 1-1 home. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Digging for second now goes Peterson. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Now batting, right fielder, Jorge
Soler. At the plate, Jorge Soler. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
2-2 to Jorge Soler. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Number five.
Next up, Freddie Freeman. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. And that misses 2-1.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in. Make him prove he can adjust before you do.
Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2. Ozzie Albies would be next. And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzy Albies. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier.
The Braves have been looking for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a big time for that.
And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Now at the plate is Jose Peraza. His prior history in this matchup, he's 0-for-4. The 1-1 is a missed drag bunt attempt for a strike. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
The third baseman.
Now back to the top of the Mets order, digging in, Jonathan Villar. The 1-1 home. Six runs, double the amount of hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. So now here is Brandon Nimmo. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Softly hit to short. He's got to hurry. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Miguel Castro is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Striding in is Austin Riley. He went deep last time up.
Yeah, he absolutely torched a fastball his last time up. Pretty much a no-doubter, so he's got to be feeling pretty confident right here.
Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2. And that misses 2-2.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
Down the line and fair. That's a hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. He'll get it into second, but he'll be in there with a double.
The center fielder, Adam Duvall.
Stepping in now, Adam Duvall. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Towards second. And this is taken for the out. The next to bat for Atlanta, Travis d'Arnaud. In his career versus this pitcher, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Here comes the 1-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. Richard Rodriguez enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set for the start of the inning, and with it comes Francisco Lindor to the plate. The 3-1. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth. So here's Pete Alonso. Hit sharply on the ground, and that's in there for a base hit, his third hit of the game. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
The right fielder, Michael Conforto.
At the plate now, Michael Conforto. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. And that brings up Javi Baez. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. Grounded to the right. And that is into right field, a base hit. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. It's a 7-2 ball game. Luis Guillorme will get the call to pinch hit here, and he'll find he has a couple of runners aboard with only one out in the inning. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Duvall is there now, and he has it, two gone. So next to bat will be James McCann. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. And the 2-1. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Two on, two out with a base open here as a pitcher. You have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here.
Oh, and this kicks right off of him. And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Jerry's Familia, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. So stepping in is Dansby Swanson. He'll lead it off against Jerry's Familia, who'll try to close the door in this one. The 1-2. Popped him up. VR waits on it. And that's the first out of the inning. So the next to bat will be Jock Peterson. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
2-2. Hit to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next up is Jorge Soler. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Final strike for the Braves. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's full count now, 3-2.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with his slider release and at least
swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
And this evening's ends at a 7-2 finish. The Metropolitans jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Carlos Carrasco gets the W on the mound. Jesse Chavez worked only three innings in the losing effort. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
the final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious New York Mets. 7 runs on 14 hits. No errors. They left 11 men on base. For Atlanta, 2 runs, 7 hits. No errors. They left.